This film is about methane, a greenhouse gas. Greenhouse gases have a bad name, but are actually a natural phenomenon. They're not bad or dangerous. In fact, they're much needed. Just like a greenhouse keeps the warmth of the sun inside, greenhouse gases do the same with the warmth that reaches the Earth. We call this the greenhouse effect. This is fortunate because without this greenhouse effect, the world would be ice and ice cold. But as with many things, too much is not always good. With too many greenhouse gases, the heat of the sun, due to a thick blanket of gases, is less able to return to space and thus remains on Earth. We call this the enhanced greenhouse effect. This effect has increased the Earth's temperature over the past 50 years. The three main greenhouse gases that cause this increase are carbon dioxide, or CO2, nitrous oxide, and methane. CO2 is the most popular among the three and accounts for about 70% of the greenhouse effect. CO2 has a natural cycle between humans, animals, and plants. You probably know, people and animals exhale CO2, plants absorb it. However, CO2 released from fossil fuels is something different. These come on top of the natural cycle, which creates a large surplus. CO2 remains in the atmosphere for thousands of years. Thus, we don't just pass it on to our grandchildren, but also our great, 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 great... Well, you get the idea. The solution? To reduce emissions. Nitrous oxide is less known. One of the ways nitrous oxide is released is by the use of nitrogen as fertilizer in the agricultural sector. As a greenhouse gas, it is almost 300 times as powerful as CO2 and is responsible for about 7% of the greenhouse effect. The breakdown of nitrous oxide also takes a very long time, potentially hundreds of years. The solution? To reduce emissions. Lastly, methane. Methane is mainly released by livestock farming, the cultivation of rice, landfill, and the extraction of natural gas. As a greenhouse gas, methane is about 34 times stronger than CO2 and is responsible for about 20% of the greenhouse effect. That's a significant contribution. But there is something special going on with methane. Methane, being unique in this lofty list, does actually disappear quickly from the atmosphere. That is, not in millennia, not in centuries, but just decades. Due to new methane being constantly released into the atmosphere, the concentration of it remains high. Yet, if we could reduce this amount, the methane would quickly decrease, and the thick blanket of greenhouse gases could potentially get a little thinner. Conclusively, we can state that great opportunities lie with methane. Therefore, we research ways to reduce methane emissions in livestock farming. Please visit wur.eu/methane.